It's time for English on the Go, so we're going to take a look at Catherine's full clip where she talks to us about how she's really good at keeping promises with other people, but sometimes the promises she makes to herself, she's not as good as keeping them. Let's find out more.
Just wanna ignite ya!
Are you ready? Go!
I think promises are really important and they mean something. I know that some people don't really hold much value in them and they're okay with making a promise and breaking a promise, but I really take it in a very serious way when I make a promise to someone. I do have a problem keeping promises to myself though, and I've realized that and I want to work on that because I think keeping promises to yourself is just as important as making a promise to someone else. And it just really helps you to stay true to who you are, and it sort of defines your character. So I think promises are really important, and it just makes you a more trustworthy person, and it's a value that I really value.
네, 오늘의 핵심 어휘 볼까요? 첫 번째로 나오는 어휘는요, 어떤 것을 정의하다 또는 규정하다라는 뜻을 갖고 있는 define. Define 이것이 명사형으로 바뀌면서 definition이라고 해서 사전적인 어떤 정의, 사전에 나와 있는 어떤 단어의 뜻을 말할 때 definition이라고 하죠. 그런데 동사 형태를 본 겁니다. Define. 그 다음으로 인격이나 기질이나 품격을 나타내는 character가 있는데요. Character는 물론 영화에 나오는 등장인물, 캐릭터를 가리킬 수도 있지만 이런 뜻도 갖고 있습니다. 그 다음 세 번째, 신뢰할 만한, trustworthy. 중간에 나오는 worth, W-O-R-T-H는 worth 발음이 되지만 이렇게 Y가 붙으면 worthy가 아니고요. worthy가 됩니다. trustworthy. 발음 연습 함께 해볼까요?
Let's practice our pronunciation. Repeat after me, starting with define, define, define. Next we have character, character, character. And lastly we have trustworthy, trustworthy, trustworthy. Perfect. How about we take a look at our clip once again, but with English subtitles.
I think promises are really important and they mean something. I know that some people don't really hold much value in them and they're okay with making a promise and breaking a promise, but I really take it in a very serious way when I make a promise to someone. I do have a problem keeping promises to myself, though, and I've realized that, and I want to work on that, because I think keeping promises to yourself is just as important as making a promise to someone else. And it just really helps you to stay true to who you are, and it sort of defines your character. So I think promises are really important, and it just makes you a more trustworthy person, and it's a value that I really value.
I think trustworthiness is a good value to value, you know?
마지막 문장에서 value, 가치다 하면서 어떻게 하는 가치인지를 말하려다가 다른 단어보다는 딱 그냥 value가 value. 잘 맞아서 yeah. 지금 value, value가 나왔는데요. 잠시 후에 같이 다시 보겠습니다.
Yeah.
자, 그럼 첫 번째 문장부터 공부해볼까요?
Sounds great.
I think promises are really important and they mean something. I know that some people don't really hold much value in them and they're okay with making a promise and breaking a promise.
I think promises are really important and they mean something.
I think, 제 생각에는 저는 이렇게 생각합니다. 뭐뭐인 것 같습니다. Mm-hmm. Promises are really important. Mm-hmm. 약속은 정말 중요하다고 생각하고 mm-hmm. 그 다음으로 I think 연결되죠. Mm-hmm. They mean something. They mean something. 우리말로도 비슷하게 받아들일 수 있을 것 같아요. 무언가를 의미한다. Of course, everything means something.
Right?
뭐든지 뭐 어떤 의미가 있죠.
Of course. 네. But in this case, I guess she means that they're a little bit more valuable or a little more important.
It has significance.
Yes.
중요성이 있다.
That's a good word.
Yeah. significance. 뭐, meaning하고 비슷한 뜻인데요.
Yeah.
의미 또는 중요성이라고 쓸 수 있습니다. 그래서 they mean something, they have some meaning.
Yeah.
여러 가지 가능한 표현 중에서 그냥 가장 편하게 쓸 수 있는 말을 yes. 써주신 것 같아요.
Yeah, they mean something.
They mean something
right?
to me. 나에게는 뭔가 의미가 있어요.
Yeah,
they mean
important.
They mean nothing to me 하면 저한테는 그거 yeah. 어떻게 되든 상관 yeah. 없어요.
You don't care, right? Oh, that means nothing to me. Mm-hmm. I don't care what she said or what they did.
You can say so and so means something about a person too. She means a lot to me. She means nothing to me. 이렇게.
Oh yeah, she means a lot to me. She's important to me. I care about her. 네. She means nothing to me.
네.
I don't like her.
이 구조를 좀 여러 가지로 응용을 해봤습니다. 의미가 있다고 생각하고요.
Next, she says, I know that some people don't really hold much value in them.
Hold 어떤 것을 잡고 있는 걸 말하죠.
We're holding cards.
We're holding cards. We're not holding hands, but we could
we're not.
if we wanted
That's
to.
That's weird.
뭔가를 잡는 거잖아요. 이렇게 uh-huh. 손 잡는 것처럼. Mm-hmm. 그래서 여기서는 hold much value yeah. in them. 여기서 mm-hmm. them은 바로
the promises.
promises. 그래서 약속 안에 가치를 잡고 있다는 것은 가치를 둔다. 우리말로는 둔다라고 yes. 하는 것과 의미가 같습니다. 그래서 mm-hmm. 저는 some people, 어떤 사람들은 별로 약속에 큰 가치를 두지 않는다는 거 알아요. 그러니까 약속을 별로 중요하게 여기지 않는다는 거 알고 있습니다.
All right. And she describes that more by saying, and they're okay with making a promise and breaking a promise, right?
네, be okay with라고 하면은 뭐뭐 해도 괜찮다. 그게 별로 중요하거나 어떤 나에게 영향을 주지 않는 경우에 쓸 수 있는 말인데,
yes.
먼저 이 뜻을 보기 전에 발음 아까 들어보셨을 때, mm-hmm. 그 앞에 나왔던 they don't hold much value in them 이게 mm-hmm. 들렸더라도 그 다음으로 and they are okay 이 부분이 좀 굉장히 부드럽게 넘어갔거든요.
Yeah.
그래서 value in them and they're okay.
Value in them and they're okay.
And they're okay.
With me.
And they're okay.
And
이렇게
they're
되면서
okay.
they가 they가 좀 약하게 들렸을 수
yeah,
있어요.
Yeah, we do that a lot. And they're okay. Like and they're okay.
Yeah, and they're and they're.
And they're.
마치 이제 in there 그 안에처럼 더 들릴 수 있을 것
oh,
같아요.
Oh yeah. Is it in there?
Yeah, and they're and they're okay. 이렇게
there?
발음했습니다.
It's in there. Okay.
이따가 다시 들려드릴 때 확인해 보시고요. Okay. And they're okay with making a promise and breaking a promise.
Yes.
그래서 약속을 한 다음에 어겨도 괜찮다고 무방하다고 생각한다는 것도 I know 맨 앞에 나왔어요.
Mm-hmm.
알고 있습니다.
All right. Let's find out what else she has to say.
But I really take it in a very serious way when I make a promise to someone. I do have a problem keeping promises to myself though, and I've realized that and I want to work on that.
But I really take it in a very serious way when I make a promise to someone.
어떤 사람들은 약속을 중요하게 여기지 않는다는 거 알지만 저는 I really take it 어떤 것을 받아들입니다. Take가 가져가는 것도 take지만 받아들이는 거. 그래서
yes.
Don't take it personally 이런 말도 있고요.
Yes, don't take it personally or don't take it seriously.
네.
It's a joke.
맞아요. 어떤 okay. 농담했을 때 개인적인 어떤 감정이 나쁜 말로 받아들이지 말아라. 감정 상하지 말아라. Don't take it personally 아니면 don't take it seriously mm-hmm. 너무 진지하게 받아들이지 말아라 그건데 여기서는 don't she takes it in a very serious way mm-hmm. 아주 진지하게 심각하게 받아들입니다
mm-hmm.
when I make a promise to someone mm-hmm. 누군가에게 약속을 하면 앞에 요약 문장에서는 promises with everyone else 썼는데 여기서는 또 방향 나타내서 to someone 썼습니다
mm-hmm. she says I do have a problem keeping promises to myself, though.
Mm-hmm. Keeping 다음에 promises to myself.
To myself.
다시 한번 나오고 있죠. To. Mm-hmm. So I do have a problem. 그런데 그러니까 약속 자체를 진지하게 받아들이지만 그런데 어려움이 있긴 있어요.
Mm-hmm.
Problem이라고는 했지만 이거를 그냥 문제
mm-hmm.
or an issue.
An issue.
이렇게. 하기보다는 여기서는 she has trouble.
Yeah, she has trouble.
네, 어려움을 겪는다는 이야기예요.
Right. So it's not a problem doesn't have to be serious. It's like oh, I have a problem with eating too many sweet potatoes.
Yeah, so
right?
In that case it's actually a problem
oh, that's
that
true.
She has to try to solve.
That's true. That's
But in
true.
This case she's saying that it is difficult.
It's difficult,
for
right?
her. 어렵다는 이야기로 말하고 있어요.
Mm-hmm.
그래서 그 미묘한 차이가 좀 있는데
true, true.
그래서 맨 마지막에 though 있죠? 이거를 그런데라고 생각해서 맨 앞으로 mm-hmm. 넣어주시고 그런데
mm-hmm.
제 스스로와의 약속을 지키는 것은 좀 어려움을 겪고 있대요. 남들과 약속은 잘 지키려고 노력하는데.
Right, but just not with herself or
okay.
to herself.
Mm-hmm.
Great, she says. And I've realized that, and I want to work on that.
그리고 그렇다는 사실을 I've realized 지금 깨달은 상태고요.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to work on
work
that.
Work on that.
Work on 하면 그 위에서 일한다는 말도 뭐. 어떻게 하면 만들 수 있겠지만 일반적으로는 개선하고자 노력하는 걸 말해요. Say you are working on your English.
Yeah.
영어 실력을 늘리기 위해 노력 중인 거고요.
Yeah. So when you're working on something, you're just trying to make it better or improve it,
yeah.
right?
I know you sometimes work on your British accent.
Oh, yes. I love to work on my British accent. So 네. I watch many dramas from England.
That's enough.
Is it?
다음 부분 볼까요?
yes.
Because I think keeping promises to yourself is just as important as making a promise to someone else. And it just really helps you to stay true to who you are, and it sort of defines your character.
Because I think keeping promises to yourself is just as important as making a promise to someone else.
왜냐하면 I think 이렇게 생각하기 때문이죠. Keeping promises to yourself 이게 하나의 덩어리고요. 자신과의 약속을 지키는 것이 is just as important as making a promise to someone else. 물론 여기서 조금 꼬이긴 했어요. keeping이었다가 갑자기 making이 된 거긴 한데 mm-hmm. 구어체에서는 이런 실수 있을 수 있죠. Mm-hmm. 실수라고 보기에도 너무 사소하지만 아무튼 약속하는 거예요. 그래서 yeah. 남과 약속하는 것도 내가 스스로와 약속을 지키는 것이 사실 동등하게 중요하다. 원래는 그래도 원래는 keeping a promise라고 말하고 싶지 않았을까 그냥 추측은 해볼
right.
수 있겠죠.
Of course.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And she says next. And it just really helps you to stay true to who you are and it sort of defines your character.
자, 여기에 단어들이 좀 나오죠. 정의하다, 규정하다.
Define, define.
예문을 볼까요?
Mm-hmm. For example, it's a term that's hard to define.
정의 내리기 어려운 용어입니다. 이렇게도 mm-hmm. 만들 수 있겠는데, define. Mm-hmm. Define 같은 경우에는 이제 definition, 정의 또는 선명도란 뜻으로 우리가 mm-hmm. TV나 어떤 카메라 이야기할 때 HD, oh. high definition, 고선명도를 가리키기도
right.
해요. 그리고 어떤 사람들이 운동을 할 때 근육이 갈라지는
definition.
것도 definition을 만들기 위해서.
You can see it more clearly. I mean, but it makes sense. When you define something, you explain it or show it clearly.
그렇죠.
So you can see it more
네.
clearly.
경계를 애매모호하게 넘어가는 것이 아니고 경계가 딱 선명해지니까 그게
yeah.
다 defined, definition, your arms are more defined 하면 mm-hmm. 근육이 갈라진 것이
you
보인다라는 의미죠.
Mm-hmm.
그런 뜻으로 쓰는 말이고요. Mm-hmm. 그 다음으로 나오는 단어가
character.
네.
character.
캐릭터를 그냥 캐릭터라고만 보기에는 너무 이제 뜻이 많죠. 그래서
yes.
인격, 기질, 어떤 품격 이런 걸 나타냅니다. 그래서 it just really helps you to help 다음에 to를 쓸 수도 있고 안 쓸 수도 있어요. Help
mm-hmm.
helps you stay 아니면 helps you to stay 둘 다 괜찮고요.
Mm-hmm.
이 부분이 좀 어려울 수 있는데 stay true to who you are.
Uh-huh. When you stay true to who you are, basically you stick to your values. Mm-hmm. You don't pretend to be something you're not.
맞아요.
Yeah.
그래서 stay true라고 하면은 그 노래 중에도 true to your heart라는 mm-hmm. 노래도 있잖아요. 그 자신이 마음이 시키는 건 이건데 다른 행동을 하거나
right.
다른 결정을 내리면 나중에 양심의 가책을 느낄 수 있잖아요.
Of
그래서
course.
그 마음이 시키는 대로 하는 걸 말하기 때문에 true라는 것은 the same.
The same, right? It's the same. Follow what your heart wants to do. Mm-hmm. Follow what you believe to be right as a person.
That's staying true to your heart or your heart. Yourself to who you are.
Yes.
자신이 누군가인지에 대한 머릿속에 생각이 있잖아요.
Mm-hmm.
그걸 그대로 유지하는 거, 신의를 지키는 거.
Mm-hmm.
신념을 지키는 걸 말하고요.
Mm-hmm.
And it sort of defines your character.
Mm-hmm.
그것이 그 사람의 character, 됨됨이를
mm-hmm.
정의해 줍니다.
Mm-hmm.
네, 이 문장 이해 되셨나요?
Oh, I hope you did.
Yeah.
Let's move on to the last part.
So I think promises are really important and it just makes you a more trustworthy person and it's a value that I really value.
So I think promises are really important and it just makes you a more trustworthy person.
그래서 I think promises are really important. 약속은 정말 중요하다고 생각하고
mm-hmm.
and it just makes you a more
trustworthy. Trustworthy.
네, trustworthy person.
Mm-hmm.
발음은 trustworthy가 아니고 worthy.
Trustworthy.
네, 신뢰할 만한, 믿을 만한. 그래서 신뢰할 수 있는 사람으로 만들어 주는 것 같습니다.
Mm-hmm.
예문 보죠.
For example, you can say Is this a trustworthy company?
어떤 회사와 계약을 하기 전에 여기
right?
믿을 만한 회사인가요?
Yeah.
네.
Are they trustworthy? Will
yeah.
they steal my money? Right.
그리고 여기 보면은 promises are really important라고 했는데 it makes you a more trustworthy person 이렇게 연결되려면 물론 이제 여기 포함된 의미는 keeping promises.
Keeping, yeah.
약속을 지켜야 더 right. 신뢰할 사람이 되겠죠.
Just not making them, right? Yeah. You've got to keep them too.
그다음 마지막 문장 볼까요?
Uh-huh. Lastly, she says, and it's a value that I really value.
이 문장이 뭐 틀린 거 아닙니다.
No, 네. it's perfect.
그래서 it's a value that I really value. Yeah. 제가 value 자체가 소중하게 여기다라는 동사고 그 다음으로 명사로서는 가치, 소중하게 여기는 가치입니다. 우리말로는 yeah. 더 자연스럽게 흘러가는 것 같은데
right.
만약에 마지막에 이 동사가 이제 value밖에 떠오르지 않아서 이렇게 했지만 다른 동사를 썼더라면 어떤 걸 쓸 수 있었을까요? What other verbs she, could
it's
she have used?
It's a value that I really think is important.
That works?
Yeah.
It's a value
I couldn't
that I...
think of just one exact word.
Yeah.
Right?
I would say the same thing. Really... It's a value that I really think is important, that uh-huh. I really means a lot to me.
Yeah.
그런 것들.
That I really find significant.
네. 아마도 지금 그 캐서린 씨 머릿속에도 그런 것들이 떠올랐다가 그냥 value,
value.
한 것 같아요.
Yeah, you can use the same one. I mean,
All right.
why not?
Yeah, that's it.
Perfect. Let's review her clip once again.
I think promises are really important and they mean something. I know that some people don't really hold much value in them and they're okay with making a promise and breaking a promise, but I really take it in a very serious way when I make a promise to someone. I do have a problem keeping promises to myself though, and I've realized that and I want to work on that because I think keeping promises to yourself is just as important as making a promise to someone else. And it just really helps you to stay true to who you are, and it sort of defines your character. So I think promises are really important, and it just makes you a more trustworthy person, and it's a value that I really value.